hunter, or chef whose ideal shopping trips are planned excursions to grocery stores. I create an Excel spreadsheet with ingredient lists arranged by store, store sections, crowd estimates, cleanliness factors, and a special notation for sale items. I like to shop quickly, you know, too long in a disorganized space, I break out in hives. But while living in Japan years ago, my new boss from Spain suggested a restaurant lunch the next day to meet his wife. Instead, I offered to them their favorite dish, shrimp paella. My little local store didn't have much selection. Then I had an idea. My guidebook said the world's freshest seafood could be found out downtown Tokyo's Tsukiji Market. Why would the world's freshest shrimp? I can make the best paella on the planet, impress my boss, and angle for a raise. The next day, I implemented my detailed plan. I left Ueyasu Station at 3:45 a.m. I transferred twice. I exited Tsukiji Station at 4:25 a.m. At 4:32 a.m., I approached the smallest door entrance to Tsukiji. I'd shop, be back at the station in 20 minutes, and be home by 6 a.m. Plenty of time to prepare our lunchtime feast. Well, I entered the door, and I edged around some stacked crates of long-necked clams, and I froze. Well, the guidebook said 43 football fields in size, but I'm not a sports person. There was this jumble of stalls piled high with ice and seafood, and on the top, in the center of each stall, there was this platform, and on top of the platform was this Japanese black apron clad fish salesman shouting. Tsukiji's vast corrugated metal roof boomed and echoed with this cacophony of sound. Well, there was no aisles or friendly aisle signs to find my shrimp. The stalls stretched and disappeared into this ocean-smelling misty distance. 4:39 a.m. I've been standing there 7 minutes. I stepped into the maze and icy liquid poured into my shoes. On the floor was awash in 3 inches of murky fish water. Oh, and then I looked over at this nearest pile of seafood and from underneath this tangle of black and pink and purple orange tentacles, slimy squid eyeballs glared back. My skin began to itch. So I splashed forward past stall after stall, ignoring the fish water, wicking up my pants. Salmon, barracuda, bass, grouper, halibut, sea urchins, clam, mussel, abalone, lobsters. So I had a sudden headache. Crabs, five crabs, black crabs, red crabs, crabs still crawling. Time to zigzag through seafood stalls scattered across 43 football fields. No, I couldn't do it without my Excel spreadsheet and fault some function buttons. It was a lot of time. My head throbbed. Well, then I saw it. Shrimp of all kinds and shapes and colors. They are 4 inch long, shell on, but heads removed, shrimp and a clearly labored placard. I recognized the symbol for yen in kilos. Let's see, I needed 4 pounds of shrimp, make it 5 just to be safe. A kilo is to a pound what a kilometer is to a mile. 2 kilometers to a mile. I'd like 10 kilos, please. I shouted in English to the man outside on top of the platform, and then he clambered down and he frowned at me. He said something like, spaghetti flung up on a wall. Maybe I should stop it, but I'd already paid. and rain. Oh, I couldn't hold my umbrella over my head and carry the bag, so I ignored the rain and I ran to the train station to catch the 16-minute direct line home. But the station was a sea of bodies. White-gloved officials stopped me in the crowd inside the train. Tokyo rush hour. My shrimp bags tangled in the legs. This is the end of business. I could possibly go wrong.